up, y'all? Welcome to Sabrina Talks. I'm Sabrina. If you're new, if you're not, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me. Now, today on Sabrina Talks, we're going to throw it back to some old school Disney, and I want to give y'all 10 songs, 10 original Disney songs that I think are still popping to this day. I feel like we've been reminiscing old school Disney a lot recently with, like, Lemonade Mouth having its 10-year anniversary, I think 15 years for Hannah Montana. And then on TikTok, I've just been seeing a lot of Disney-related songs. So it made me think of some of the original Disney Channel songs that's been on the TV shows and movies that I still listen to this day. So I wanted to share some. So let's get started with the first song. The first song I want to talk about is from Phineas and Ferb, and it's the song Busted, which is sung by Candace and Vanessa Dufresne-Smurf. This song was written by Danny Jacob and Dan Povenmire, which are the two, I think, co-creators of Phineas and Ferb and who are usually in charge of all of the music on Phineas and Ferb. Now listen, I could have chose any one of them songs from Phineas and Ferb because Phineas and Ferb has some bangers in that show, but Busted is something that I constantly sing. Like, it's really giving you like that 2000s girl group kind of situation, or maybe like a Brandy and Monica, but you know, more Disney-fied, I guess you could say. And it's just also incredibly catchy. Have you listened to that song? A masterpiece. Song number two is Potential Breakup Song by Ali and AJ. Now this technically wasn't on any show or movie to my knowledge, but it's definitely a song and a music video that was constantly on Disney Channel and on Radio Disney. So I had to include it because that song is an absolute hit. It was written by Ali and AJ and then also Antonio Armada and Tim James. It even had a resurgence on TikTok where it was hot and popping for at least a good month and some change. I did another video where I talked about its resurgence on TikTok, so you can check it out in my cards and in my description. And because of that resurgence, they even released an explicit version since they're, you know, grown up now. They only changed like a few words, so I wasn't entirely excited about the explicit version, but once again, song's an absolute hit. Song number three comes from the movie Jump In, and it is Push It to the Limit by Corbin Blue. Push it, push it. When this song came out, it peaked at number 14 on the Billboard Hot 100, which I'm shocked about, honestly, because I didn't think this would be one of the Disney songs to hit the Billboard Hot 100, but I mean, this song is a banger. Like, there's no reason why you should be listening to this song and not moving your body. Robbie Neville and Matthew Gerard both wrote this song, and they both have credits on other Disney properties such as like Big Time Rush and Hannah Montana, High School Musical, The Cheetah Girls, so they know how to craft a good Disney bop. This was also just a moment because Jump In was such like a black movie, and Corbin Blue was one of the few like black boys to be out here singing on Disney. So you'll absolutely still catch me listening to Push It to the Limit. Song number four is What Dreams Are Made Of from the iconic Lizzie McGuire movie. This was obviously sung by Hilary Duff. It's just one of the best moments of the Lizzie McGuire movie. Now that movie is, in general, it's just fantastic. But though this song is at the end, tell me you don't want to be up on that stage dancing along and singing along with her. It's a certified bop. Definitely give all your kudos to Matthew Wilder and Dean Pitchford because they both wrote this song. Also, I gotta add that the outfit Lizzie was wearing while she was performing this song is cute. I liked it when I was a child, but I still like it to this day, and I still need a recreation of the outfit, so somebody hit me up with that. Hero by Sterling Knight is my song number five. This comes from one of my favorite Disney Channel musicals, which is Starstruck. This was written by Nicki and Adam Anders and Pierre Astrom. Now this trio has been working on songs together for like Dove Cameron, Camp Rock 2, and even some songs on Glee. Personally, I think Hero is one of the best songs from this musical. Now close seconds would be In My Shades because that's a hit, but my absolute favorite is the unplugged version of Hero because Sterling Knight, mean, he got some vocals in this song, and he just was giving me everything that I needed. Plus, it's just a generally cute song. Song number 6 comes from another Disney Channel icon, and that is The Climb by Miley Cyrus, and this is from the Hannah Montana movie. This absolute hit was number 4 in the Billboard Hot 100 and was written by Jesse Alexander and John Mayde. Now, Jesse Alexander is an actual country singer and she's written her own songs, plus songs for people like Miranda Lambert and Blake Shelton. And her and John Mayde did a fantastic job, because you can't think of the 2000s without thinking of The Climb. You can't think of Hannah Montana without thinking of The Climb, because it's just that iconic. And Miley sounds country Miley, and now with the addition to rock Miley, fantastic versions of Miley, and I just adore her. Now, for song number 7, you can't technically find it on like Apple Music or on Spotify or any other music streaming service, because it's not an official full song, and I don't think they ever finished the song. It's just like a little snippet from an episode, and that song is We Are the Voice in Motion from That's So Raven. Now, this came from the episode Boys in Commotion, and it features Columbus Short, Michael Capone, and Ryan Hansen as the actual Boys in Motion. When this episode first came out, it was one of my favorite episodes of That's So Raven, because one, it's a ridiculous episode, and two, because of this song. And Boys in Motion is definitely a song that like gets stuck in my head at random points. I wouldn't have even watched the episode, but I'll just start randomly singing, "Boys, we are the boys in motion. We give you our devotion," and like I'll just start busting out dancing with it. But yeah, it's just a great Disney-fied R&B hit. I couldn't find who wrote this actual like portion of the song, but if you somehow know who wrote Boys in Motion, let me know so I can give them some kudos that they greatly deserved. Moving on to song number 8, which also features Miss Raven Simone, the icon that she is, and that song is Cinderella by the Cheetah Girls from the Cheetah Girls movie. Cinderella was written by Kevin Sevinger and Lindy Robbins, and while researching who wrote the song, I discovered that this is actually a cover, because the original group who sang Cinderella is a group called I-5, who was like a girl group from the 90s and 2000s. I feel like I never knew that, or if I did, that left my brain ages ago. But that was a nice surprise, and it technically goes against my original Disney song list that I'm planning out, but we're gonna roll with it because it's still a hit, and it's still, I imagine, the first time a lot of people heard that song. I remember as a child, I used to adore the song because one, it's the Cheetah Girls. Every song from the Cheetah Girls was popping. Maybe not every song. A good chunk of the songs from the first movie was popping, but I especially vibed with it because as a child, I was very much a girl who was like, no, I don't need no man. Girls can do anything they want. Like, I was very much that kind of girl. So I was like, yes, this is a song for me. I don't need to be saved. I was here for it. And to this day, I'm still here for it because I still believe that. I definitely think Cinderella is like one of the most R&B sounding songs from early 2000s Disney, because they was really making everything kind of a pop version and like a Disney-fied version. But this could have played on the radio and not shown up in the Cheetah Girls, and it would have been still an absolute hit. We're sticking on the Raven chain for song number 9 and going to another movie that she was featured in, and that movie is Xenon, Girl of the 21st Century. The song I want to talk about from this movie is Supernova Girl, or Zoom Zoom Zoom, and that was performed by Protozoa from like the last few scenes of the movie. And I mean, have you heard it? Have you seen Xenon, Girl of the 21st Century? Were you jamming out as hard as I was as a child? Because you would already know why this song is on my list, because it's a banger. Supernova Girl was written by Kristen Rex, and I think they worked on Smart House before this and then actually wrote this song. Now, you can't find this, I don't think, on Spotify or Apple Music, but what you can find it on is SoundCloud, because that's how I found it and I was listening to it there. But this is a song that for some reason, I don't always remember Xenon, Girl of the 21st Century, because like I watched that ages ago and I haven't really watched it as of recently, But I will always remember that song because it'll come to my head at the randomest moments and I'll just be singing zoom, zoom, zoom all the time. It's such a catchy song because, I mean, there's not much lyrics to it and most of the lyrics are in relation to space, so you can easily remember it. It also has like a dance kind of EDM hip hop-ish vibe to it, which is also why I enjoy it so much. The last song I want to talk about is definitely one of my favorites from this list because it comes from one of my favorite musicals out of the Disney Channel musicals, and that is Work This Out from High School Musical 2. Work, work, work this out. We'll make things right. Work This Out was written by Kevin Quinn and Randy Peterson, and they both worked on a majority of the songs from the High School Musical trilogy. In my personal opinion, High School Musical 2 is the best out of the trilogy because it has some of the best songs. Work This Out is one of them. It's definitely one of the more groovier songs from High School Musical because I think it has more of like a R&B stylings to it, to where you can do some fancy footwork and such like that. So I think that's also why it leans towards me more, but song's a banger. Now that you know the 10 original Disney Channel songs that I still listen to this day, let me know in the comments down below which songs that you still listen to. Let me know if you would like to see me do more songs because I can give you another 10 easily. You can also let me know on my socials at Sabrina Talks 2 on Instagram and Twitter, and at Sabrina Talks 2 you on TikTok. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like, subscribe to my channel, and ring the bell for more music and entertainment related content. Share this video with your friends so we can all reminisce on some great Disney Channel songs. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Please remember to be safe, be smart, be kind, and I'll see y'all in my next video. Bye, guys.